Hello there, welcome to Cool Talk. And now we're beginning the 1980s year by year. President Jimmy Carter was having problems with Iran. They had taken American hostages. And then the Soviet Union had invaded Afghanistan. In response, Jimmy Carter said that the Americans would boycott the Olympics that were being held in Moscow that year. He also placed a grain embargo to punish the Soviet Union. But the Soviets got their grain elsewhere, and all this served was to punish the American farmer. As for Iran is concerned, Iran would not release the hostages, they said, until the U.S. would return the Shah of Iran. The Shah, by this point, dying of cancer, had gone to Egypt where he passed away. But Iran would not release the hostages. Joy Adamson, naturalist, was assassinated by a former employee. Dr. Herman Tarnover was shot dead by a lover. Now, Dr. Tarnover was the author of the Scarsdale Medical Diet. John Lennon from the Beatles, musician, shot dead by a deranged fanatic, Mark Chapman. And then Anastasio Somoza, who had fled Nicaragua, was tracked down and killed. His car, where he was riding, was shot full of bullets and hit with a bazooka. Then, in Salvador, the Archbishop Romero was shot to death while he was holding mass. And also in Salvador, four nuns were raped and killed. Colonel Harlan Sanders, founder of KFC, died at the age of 90. Jesse Owens, Olympic athlete, also passed away. Jimmy Durante, comedian and actor, died. And director Alfred Hitchcock passed away, as well as actors Steve McQueen, Peter Sellers, and Mae West. 36 died with the eruption of the volcano in Mount St. Helens. Author Henry Miller died, but no one cried when smallpox was dead. The disease had been eradicated. It was the year that Sugar Ray Leonard lost his first fight to Panamanian champion Roberto Duran, but Leonard would get his revenge just a few months later. Pope John Paul II visited six African nations.
Private matter.
You never came to the hospital.
Now,
how do you
comrade,
know about the
your
hospital?
Your mother did come to the hospital, comrade, and you know.
There's no way I'm going down. I don't go down for nobody.
Listen with him. Why does he have to make it so hard on himself?
Fly this plane and land it.
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious, and don't call me Shirley.
Do that to me one more time. I can never get it.
The da 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 is all I want to say to you.
Remember my name, babe. I'm gonna live forever. I want to take.
The ladies pimp, the women fight for my death.
Sailing takes me away to where I'm
going. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small.
In India, Prime Minister Indira Gandhi had won a massive victory in Congress, but her son Sanjay died in a plane crash. He was 33. In Saudi Arabia, 63 Islamic fundamentalists violently occupied the Great Mosque a year earlier. They were all beheaded. 120,000 Cubans were allowed to emigrate to the United States in what was known as the Mariel boat lift. U.S. President Jimmy Carter authorized a military rescue of the American hostages in Iran, but it was a disaster. Before they even got there, out in the desert, two helicopters broke down. There was a collision, and eight soldiers died. Zimbabwe gains independence. In London, five terrorists seize the Iranian embassy and take 19 hostages. They would kill two of them. British special forces rescued the hostages and killed three of the gunmen. In Soviet-controlled Poland, Lech Walesa becomes chairman of a new trade union, Solidarity. 500,000 stop working at the shipyards and demand freedom of speech, the release of some political prisoners, and new labor laws. The Polish government gave in to the strikers. The strike would end after 17 days. Now, if you read the book or saw the movie The Falcon and the Snowman, you'll know about Christopher Boyce and Andrew Dalton, who had sold secrets to the Soviets from the defense industry. Christopher Boyce escaped from prison that year. He committed 17 bank robberies before he was caught about a year later. Actor-comedian Richard Pryor attempted suicide by setting himself on fire. Second and third degree burns covered one half of his body. It was the year of the elections, and Jimmy Carter was roundly defeated by Republican Governor of California, Ronald Reagan. Now, still President Jimmy Carter continued to negotiate for the release of the hostages until literally the last hour of his presidency, when Ronald Reagan was being sworn in. Half an hour after taking the oath, Iran released the hostages. For those who saw the inauguration on TV, you're probably familiar with this image. Split screen events. It was amazing. Many remember the royal wedding where Lady Diana of Wales marries Prince Charles of England. In the Abscam sting operation, a New Jersey Senator, Harrison Williams, along with a New Jersey mayor and several others, were convicted of accepting bribes. The largest naturalization event took place in the Memorial Stadium in Los Angeles, as 9,700 people became U.S. citizens. Stephen Chasek crosses the English Channel in a solar-powered plane. In the U.S., 12,000 airline strikers, air traffic controllers, went on strike and demanded changes. President Ronald Reagan fired them all. Sandra Day O'Connor became the first female Supreme Court judge. Ronald Reagan lifted the Soviet grain embargo, and he also cut taxes on the wealthy, trickle-down economics as it was called. That same year, however, there was an assassination attempt on President Reagan. A John Hinckley shot and wounded President Reagan along with some others. He said he did it to prove his love for actress Jodie Foster. General Omar Bradley, singer Bob Marley, actors William Holden and Melvin Douglas, novelist Christy Brown, and actress Natalie Wood. Egyptian President Anwar Sadat was gunned down, assassinated during a parade. In China, Mao Zedong's widow, Jiang Qing, was convicted of not being loyal to the Cultural Revolution. She was sentenced to death, but later this was commuted to life imprisonment. In Lebanon, a civil war broke out. This would involve the Syrian Arab forces, Israeli-backed militia, Islamic guerrilla, and United Nations peacekeeping forces. In Ireland, many members of the Irish Revolutionary Army went on hunger strike demanding some changes, and one of the leaders, Bobby Sands, would die of starvation after 66 days. Pope John Paul II was shot and severely wounded by Turkish anarchist Mehmet Ali Aka. Ali Aka was sentenced to life imprisonment. He would serve 30 years. During these years, Pope John Paul II forgave him and visited him in prison. When Mehmet Ali Aka was released, he converted to Catholicism and laid some flowers at Pope John Paul II's gravesite. Israeli jets destroy an Iraqi nuclear plant. The United Nations condemns the action. Mujahideen guerrillas kill the Iranian president, prime minister, and 29 others in a bomb attack. So, in retaliation, Iran kills 2,000 Mujahideen. In Gambia, President Dauda Jawara is ousted by a military coup, but within a week, the country of Senegal would place him back in power. Lieutenant General Mohammed Ershad seizes power in Bangladesh. Argentinian forces invade the Falkland Islands, which belong to the United Kingdom. The UK forces arrive on May 22nd. By June 14, Argentina had surrendered. In the meantime, though, Canada severs its last ties to the UK. Increasing pressure from around the world was placed on South Africa to free activist Nelson Mandela. Israel returns Sinai territory to Egypt as agreed. But then they invade South Lebanon, occupying the cities of Tyre and Sidon. Rebel troops overthrow the government of Chad. President Ronald Reagan extends sanctions against the Soviet Union to include Western European countries that had contracts for the Siberian pipeline. This angered the EU. In the Dominican Republic, President Antonio Guzman commits suicide. Palestinian leader Yasser Arafat accepts the UN resolution that Israel have the right to exist, but the US still doesn't recognize the Palestinian Liberation Organization. In Swaziland, King Sobhuza II dies. He was the longest reigning monarch. He had been king for almost 83 years. In Lebanon, the newly elected president, Bashir Gemayel, was assassinated. He was 34. In Poland, Labor leader Lech Walesa was arrested. He would be detained for about a year. President Jaruzelski would ban Solidarity, the labor union. Martial law was implemented. The tanks came in. The party was over, or so they thought. In the meantime, in the Soviet Union, Leonid Brezhnev dies, and the new prime minister would be Yuri Andropov.
okay, Gandhi.
Well, whoever you are, we don't want you here. I suggest you get back on that train before it leaves.
They seem to want me.
The Irish government outlaws the Irish National Liberation Party. In Nigeria, 2 million Ghanaian migrant workers are expelled. President Ronald Reagan calls the Soviet Union an evil empire. He also supports the Contras, a revolutionary movement against the Marxist Sandinista government. In Lebanon, a bomb is planted by Shiite Muslims and blows up the United States Embassy, killing 87. Later, two suicide attacks were performed on U.S. and French peacekeeping forces, killing 242 Americans and 62 French. The Americans would soon pull out. Rebels in Chad take over with a little help from Libya. In Ethiopia, a drought threatens to kill millions. The government, desperate, asks for international aid. President Marcos of the Philippines was facing opposition from Benigno Aquino. Then, in the Manila airport, Benigno Aquino was assassinated. Israeli Prime Minister Menachem Begin begins to withdraw troops from Syria. Then his wife of many years dies. He falls into a very deep depression. He resigns from office. He would be succeeded by Yitzhak Shamir. 38 IRA prisoners escape from Northern Ireland. And then in Poland, Lech Walesa wins the Nobel Peace Prize. In Grenada, Prime Minister Maurice Bishop is killed in a coup. 6,000 American troops invade and institute civil rule. Leading magazine Stern in Germany paid a lot of money for Hitler's newly discovered diaries, but it turned out that they were forged. Legislation is passed making Martin Luther King's birthday a national holiday.
In trying to save yourself, you've thrown out your character and your principles. Now, the only way you could possibly redeem yourself and be the man that God intended you to be is to admit to me anything that you might have been doing last night.
For God's sake, come in.
I'm coming in, aren't I? If that stupid bleeding handle on the door, you want to get it fixed?
Come.
jumped into her arms and said, "Will you marry me, yes or no?"
Back.
Soviet leader Andropov dies, and the new leader is Konstantin Chernenko. In the Soviet Union as well, Andrei Sakharov, dissident, goes on a hunger strike to get medical treatment for his wife. In Ethiopia, the famine goes into its second year. Millions more would die. In India, Sikh extremists occupy the Golden Temple. The army would recapture the temple, but it resulted in 250 deaths. In Poland, priest and Solidarity supporter Jerzy Popielecki was beaten to death. In India, Prime Minister Indira Gandhi was assassinated. She was succeeded by her son Rajiv. And singer Marvin Gaye was shot to death by his father in a domestic dispute. The United States establishes diplomatic relations with the Vatican after 116 years. The space shuttle, the Challenger, lands for the first time. The United States and France each independently discover the AIDS virus. The Soviets boycott the Olympics that were held in Los Angeles. And Disney celebrates Donald Duck's 50th birthday. Michael Jackson's record Thriller sells 37 million copies and wins an unprecedented 8 Grammys. In my next video, we'll continue with 1985, but in the meantime, send me your comments or your likes, or better yet, subscribe. This is Cool Talk.